do you lament those years maybe that you could have gotten that free time back and lived more?
No,
at
the
your
past
whim?
is a fiction. The past is a fiction. Don't spend any time thinking about the past. It doesn't exist. It's not real.
Yeah.
No one can
Okay.
time
More.
travel
Yeah.
back.
More advice then.
Yeah.
Or
No, it's just
counsel for
complete
others.
waste of time to think about the past. There's nothing there. You can't go back. Yeah, maybe if you have some important lessons to learn, but you know, those lessons can be learned pretty fast. You can synthesize that data very quickly. There's no need to reminisce upon the past. I think people get trapped. A lot of people are sorting out their past when the past is just entirely contained in your head. It's not anywhere else. And so the easiest way is just to kind of get over any problems or reinterpret them in a way that it serves you and just move on, because the present is all that actually exists. So that's where you live, that's where you exist, that's what you got to spend time on and time within. And any moment where you're not present, you're literally squandering time. So I had this thought today, actually, coincidentally, which is, what is a good use of time? How should time be spent, right? How do you know that you're getting the most out of every moment? And so then I was like, okay, well, I want the time to be useful and engaging, and I don't want to be too mentally disturbed or anxious while I'm in that time. So what is that? Well, there's flow state. I could be in flow, but flow, the way that it was defined narrowly in that famous book, I forget the author's name, but it's like a difficult Russian or Polish name, but so forgive me for that. But the way flow was defined in that book was that you were engaged in a task at the edge of your capability, where you were good enough at it that you could actually pull it off, but not so good at it that it wasn't challenging to you. So you're doing challenging work at the edge of your capability, and that's flow, and that's a good use of time. Well, that's like a couple hours a day. That's not good enough. What about the rest of my day? And so I thought about it, and like, really what you want out of your time is you want to be in flow every moment. And how do you get into flow every moment, whether you're brushing your teeth or walking the dog or reading a book or speaking in Clubhouse? Well, you have to do it in such a way that you're completely engaged, you're fully aware, you're completely present. What does that mean? That means that your mind isn't running out of control. So ultimately, if you don't want to waste time, your mind has to be under control. And you can't control your mind. It's an uncontrollable monkey. Now we're in catch 22 land. So all you can do is be aware of your mind being out of control, because that gives you a level of detachment from your mind that then lets you be in flow. So the very, very subtle answer to the very difficult question of how you should spend your time, the answer is by being self-aware within every moment.
Yeah, I think a lot of people, they try to get better, but it's just become more observant of who you are, and you will automatically just get better. Like if you could, or you don't, but all you can control is just being aware of what you're doing. There's just far too much going on, where you were born, what languages you speak, who you were born to. Like there's so many variables that you know, this present moment consists of. All you can do is just observe as much of it as possible.
Well, you are a play of a set of infinite forces launched from the Big Bang, intersecting at this precise moment. Your inputs into that and your ability to control that are incredibly limited, if they exist at all. So the best thing to do is, of course, function to the best of your capability, but just be as aware as possible, as self-aware as possible, because you're always aware of the environment around you, right? So your awareness always extends into the environment. The problem is it extends too far out into the environment. You lose your self-awareness. Then your mind starts running crazy. You're constantly reacting to things. The moment slips away from you because you're lost in the past or the future, which don't really exist, and your time is wasted. But if you are immersed in the activity because your mind is quiet, and generally it's quiet because you're self-aware of it when it's running around, then there's a certain level of flow state that you can enter into your everyday life, and that is time well spent.
Yeah, my little hack for this is just trying to zoom in, right? Like even the tiniest like bite of food or sip of water or like whatever can be a deeply immersive experience and pull you into the present.
Well, it's like the first level was 100% free time, and then the second level is 100% flow state.
Yeah, I think that's right. Well, and it doesn't, the beauty is if you get 100% flow state, it doesn't even have to be free time. So free time, in a sense,
True.
Is a crutch. It's a crutch because you don't know how to be immersed in whatever it is that you're doing. And a truly present person, you know, almost like an enlightened Buddha-like being, would be perfectly happy whether he or she was busting rocks in a chain gang or, you know, playing video games or sitting there and staring out into space.
Well, it's I had a tweet today. It said, if, you know, we often use this term at Gumroad, like we want to help creators earn a living doing what they love. And I sort of joked, like, the easiest way to make a living is to, or doing what you love, is to fall in love with making money. Like, if you love the act of doing it, then inherently, you know, like, and it's kind of the same with all of these things. You just fall in love with it. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, so what you're basically saying there then is fall in love with life itself, which is hard for most people to do. It's not easy.
So you either make life better so that you fall in love with it, or you become okay with falling in love with what you currently have. Like, both, I think, sort of, and I think life is like basically both of those things for everybody to some degree.
Well, one of my favorite tweets of all time is by Charlie Knowles, who I followed on Twitter for a while. And he tweeted that at the end of the day, you have to believe that either everything is a miracle or nothing is. And that's a very deep statement. Basically, if you believe in a single miracle, like, for example, if, like, I don't know, if the Holy Spirit just popped up and performed one miracle in front of you, that means then there are miracles everywhere, because you can't take anything for granted. Everything has to be a miracle. Or you're completely atheistic and you believe that there are no miracles. It was all just kind of random. But that one simple, the answer to that one simple question will basically define your entire worldview. But it has to be an authentic answer. Unfortunately, we're mostly agnostic.
Most yeah, of it's, just wander it's funny. It's like, it's so easy to find out if you're happy, which is like, you know, at this moment, everyone can ask themselves, like, at this moment, do I have what I want? Would I change something about this moment? I personally would not right now. Then you're happy. And if there is a change that you want, if you want it, you can either stop wanting it. That's sort of maybe preferred and the cheapest option, or you get what you want. And then maybe you like, those are just the two outcomes. It's kind of like what you said, you know, life is, what is it? Two questions, right? What do you want? And did you get it?